The idea was to use a flight simulator to remove from a plane model the motor and replace this motor with Typhoon. The only difference between what you can see here and with H55 is that in H55, all is modeled in Typhoon. The key advantages in working with H55 using Typhoon was to limit time for developing a system and with a limited number of unknowns before prototyping. It's also a nice tool to teach new pilots what are the specificities of electric airplane. Simulate some troubles in power electronics in the drive, but using a real cockpit. So it's not only for research and development, it's also for educating pilots. Why not technicians? There is quite no limit in that kind of environment. But such kind of tool is quite easy to be used. When you use it the first time, it's installed in 5 to 6 minutes. Then you start with very simple example and it works, it's nice.
One of your most important products are your students and what they learn in the lab so that they can go to industry and implement all they have learned.
Thanks to students, we make this transfer of technology from university to industry. And I think the students will import maybe Typhoon for in their future employer because they will be able to make the demonstration that, okay, it's maybe a bit expensive, but we can do a lot with it. And you can save time and money.
It saves a lot. In the end of the day, the price is a relative thing to the value that it brings, because any crashed drive or burned battery pack, or it's also costly in various ways.
In power electronics, when we want to develop something, you have to deal with energy. And you cannot cheat with energy. Each time you do something wrong, you have some burn and some fires. Doing some pretest on real-time simulation, then you can see tons of problems you can avoid. And then the first prototyping is the good one. You cannot make something burning. HIL testing means development with no risk.